Liquid crystals, mesomorphic state. When certain solids get heated, it undergoes two sharp transformations, one after the other. Two sharp transformations, or solid first fuses sharply at a particular temperature to yield turbid liquids or liquid crystals. Then this again equally sharply at a higher temperature, it yields pure liquids. This can be reversed on cooling at the same temperature. Turbid liquids show an isotropic property. Clear liquids or true liquids show isotropic properties. Anisotropic property means have a different physical properties in different directions. Isotropic property means have different properties in different directions. Liquid crystals have properties like mobility, surface tension, viscosity, etc. Liquid crystals, or otherwise known as crystalline liquids, anisotropic liquids, and mesomorphic state. Mesomorphic state is nothing but intermediate form. This fits best, but the name liquid crystals still continues. A large number of organic compounds with long chain molecules such as cholesterol acetate, para acyl anisole, cholesterol benzoate, ammonium oleate are the few examples of this liquid crystals. Applications of liquid crystals. The important application of liquid crystals is the display devices. Liquid crystal displays, that is LCD, are used in watches, calculators, laptops and computer screens, and for instrumentation in cars, ships and aeroplanes. Types of liquid crystals. Liquid crystals are composed of organic rod-shaped molecules that are lined in parallel. The common types used in electronic displays are smectic, pneumatic and cholesteric liquid crystals. Now we are going to see smectic. The smectic have limited mobility. Flow in the layers is different sheets or blending over one another. Distribution of velocity is different. Layers is different from that found in a true liquid. Concept of viscosity is not applicable. When this liquid crystals spread over a clean glass surface, then it forms a series of terraces or strata. The edges of these terraces often show a series of fine lines even in ordinary light, though more so in polarized light. This gives X-ray diffraction patterns like solid crystals. The smectic show fan-like structure under polarized light. They are uniaxial and not affected by magnetic field. Example for smectic are ethyl para azyl benzoate, ethyl para azyl cinnamate. Pneumatic. Pneumatic liquid crystals have normal flow behavior of liquids. The flow is more rapidly than the smectic liquid crystals. The concept of viscosity is applicable to their flow, that is, viscosity is rather low as compared to that of the liquids. The pneumatic have a turbid and anisotropic character. This shows a thread-like structure under polarized light. They are uniaxial and are strongly affected by magnetic field. In strong magnetic field, the turbid liquid appears quite pure. When magnetic field is cut off, the liquid appears to be turbid again. Example for this pneumatic are para azoxy anisole and para azoxy phenytoin. The third one is cholesteric liquid crystals. Cholesteric liquid crystals. Liquid crystals having some pneumatic and some smithic characters are called cholesteric liquid crystals. Certain optically active compounds show many characteristics of this pneumatic behavior, but at the same time they show strong color effects in polarized light. They have layer structure like smithic liquid crystal, but they differ from smithic liquid crystals in having much thicker layers, which are of the order 500 to 5000 molecules thick. Example for this cholesteric liquid crystals are cholesterol benzoate and L-cholesterol formate. These are all the structure of smithic, pneumatic and cholesteric liquid crystals. Swamp theory of liquid crystals. The best explanation for turbidity is given on the basis of Swamp theory. The Swamp theory was proposed by Bose. Substance having long chains show mesomorphic behavior. Their free rotation is restricted and tend to arrange in a parallel formation. This parallel formation is nothing but number of groups or swarms or uptide. The molecules in any one swarm are parallel to another but may not be parallel to those present in another swarm. Each swarm consisting of several molecules arranged parallel to one another considered as a small crystal. Turbid liquid is viewed as consisting of a series of small crystals distributed at random in a body of the liquid. Swarm appears as transparent liquid crystals when viewed under microscope, and this is given by Lindman. Swarm theory. The turbidity of these liquid crystals is due to the scattering of liquid at the boundaries between the various swarms. When temperature of the liquid crystal is raised, the molecule motion increases and an interchange between the swarm occurs. Swarm occurs smaller and smaller. Ultimately, at a certain temperature, the swarm becomes smaller than half of the wavelength of the light. They are then too small to scatter light. The turbid then disappears. The liquid becomes very clear. The double refraction and other anisotropic properties due to orientation of molecules within the swarm get disappears. The liquid becomes singly refracting and isotropic. The arrangement of molecules in an isotropic liquid is given in the figure, that is in a collapsed manner. There is no any structural shape of crystals are present. Thank you.